Unit 2, Humor. Reading C. Uncle Podger hangs a picture. A new picture would have come and be standing in the dining room, waiting to be put up. And Aunt Podger would ask what was to be done with it. And Uncle Podger would say, "Oh, you leave that to me. Don't you? Any of you worry yourselves about that. I'll do that." And then he would take off his coat and begin. He would send the maid out for 6 penny worth of nails, and then one of the boys after her to tell her what size to get. And from that, he would gradually work down and start the whole house. "Now you go and get me my hammer, Will," he would shout. "And you bring me the rule, Tom, and I shall want the step ladder. And I had better have a kitchen chair too. And Jim, you run round to Mr. Goggles and tell him Daddy's best wishes and hopes his leg is better. And will he let him have his spirit level for the evening? And don't you go, Maria, because I shall want somebody to hold the light. And when the maid comes back, she must go out again for a bit of picture cord. And Tom, where's Tom? Tom, you come here. I shall want you to hand me up the picture." And then he would lift up the picture and drop it, and it would come out of the frame. And he would try to save the glass and cut himself, and then he would jump round the room looking for his handkerchief. He could not find his handkerchief because it was in the pocket of the coat he had taken off, and he did not know where he had put the coat. And all the house had to stop looking for all the other things he had asked for and start looking for his coat, while he would dance round and get in their way. "Doesn't anybody in the whole house know where my coat is? I never came across such people in all my life. Upon my word, I didn't. 6 of you. And you can't find a coat that I put down not 5 minutes ago. Well, of all the..." Then he would get up and find that he had been sitting on it and would call out, "Oh, you can give it up. I have found it myself now. I might just as well ask the cat to find anything as expect you people to find it." And when half an hour had been spent in tying something round his finger, and a new glass had been got, and the step ladder and the chair and the light had been brought, he would try again. The whole family, including the maid and the charwoman, standing round in a semicircle, ready to help. 2 people would have to hold the chair, and a third would help him to get up on it and hold him there, and a fourth would hand him a nail, and a fifth would give him the hammer, and he would take the nail in his hand and drop it. "There," he would say in an angry voice, "now the nail's gone." And we would all have to go down on our knees and look for it, while he would stand on the chair and want to know if he was to be kept there all the evening. The nail would be found at last, but by that time he would have lost the hammer. "Where's the hammer? What did I do with the hammer? 7 of you standing all round me, and you don't know what I did with the hammer?" We would find the hammer for him, and then he would have lost sight of the mark he had made on the wall, where the nail was to go in, and each of us had to get up on the chair beside him and see if we could find it. And we would each discover it in a different place, and he would call us all fools one after another and tell us to get down. And he would take the rule and measure again and find what he wanted half of 31 3/8 inches from the corner and would try to do it in his head and go mad. And we would all try to do it in our heads and all get different results. And in the noise that was being made by everybody, the original number would be forgotten and Uncle Podger would have to measure it again. He would use a bit of string this time, and at the critical moment when the old fool was trying to reach a spot 3 inches beyond what was possible for him to reach, the string would slip and down he would fall onto the piano, a really fine musical effect being produced when his head and body suddenly struck all the notes at the same time. And Aunt Maria would say that she would not allow the children to stand round and hear such language. At last, Uncle Podger would find the spot again and put the point of the nail on it with his left hand and take the hammer in his right hand, and at the first attempt he would strike his thumb and drop the hammer with a loud cry on somebody's toes. Aunt Maria would say quietly that next time Uncle Podger was going to hammer a nail into the wall, she hoped he would let her know in time so that she could make arrangements to go and spend a week with her mother while it was being done.